Hey there, Mercedes here from PrettyWebz.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make a neon brush in Photoshop. We're going to make everything here from scratch. So if you followed my tutorial last week on neon brushes for Procreate, you know that I used an image from the source library to make that. In this video, I'm going to be making a very similar image to serve as the brush nozzle. So if you prefer to work in Procreate and you want to make your own brush from scratch, you can follow what I'm doing here and just apply it inside of Procreate to get the same effect. Let's go ahead and get started with this brush. In order to create a brush in Photoshop, you have to know a few basics, and that is how color is going to affect the transparency of the brush. So we're starting here with a square canvas that is completely white. That means that if we created a brush out of this right here, it would be completely transparent. You wouldn't be able to see it. So anything that is white will be completely 100% transparent. Anything that is black will be completely 100% opaque. So you'll be able to see it. Any values between black and white will register at varying transparencies based on how close they are to black or to white. So the closer to white, more transparent. The closer to black, more opaque. I just want you to keep that in mind when we're creating this glowing style brush, because we're going to use that grayscale in order to get us that transparent glowing effect. So let's go ahead and get started again with a white background. And then I'm gonna come here to the shape tool. Now you might have like a rectangle or something else here, but you'll just click on the shape tool, click and hold it, and then come here to the ellipse. If you don't have these here, you can come here to these three little dots and add your shapes to the toolbar from there. Now I've got some colors up here for my shape. I'm going to go ahead and change this to black for the fill, and the stroke we're going to go ahead and leave at no stroke. Now I'm just going to go ahead and drag down some rulers so that I know that I'm right in the center. I'm just going to drag it until I see the snap right there, and I'll know that that's the center there. And then I'm going to come here to this side and do the same thing until I see that snap. So I know that this right here is going to be the center of my canvas. If your rulers aren't up right here, you can press Command and R or Control and R, and that will either toggle them off or on for you. With our shape selected here, I'm just going to click right here in the center, and I'm going to hold the Shift and Option key while I drag this out. That's just going to make sure that my shape is being created from the center out. So I'm going to drag this out to 100 pixels, and I'll let that go there. Now I'm going to come here to my layers, right click and rasterize this layer, and then on my keyboard, Command and the letter J. So I'm going to duplicate that layer twice and just turn those off for now. For this first ellipse, this is going to be our base. We're going to fade it 100 pixels. In order to do that, we're going to come up here to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. We're going to fade it 100. Now you can see right here how it's almost disappeared on camera. You probably can't see it at all. That's our base, and it's closer to white than it is to black. So it's going to show up, but it's going to be very faint, very transparent. Now our next one, this one, I'm going to fade this one out 50 pixels, and this one I will fade out 25 pixels. So let me do that right away. So I'm going to come to this first one, Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and we'll fade this out 50 pixels. I'm going to turn this one on and come back up here to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and I will fade this out 25 pixels. You can do more or less, just depends on the style that you're going for, but you can see how we're gradually fading out to white here. Now I'm going to make the first brush with all three of these showing. So we're going to come here to Edit, up at the top, Define Brush Preset. I'm going to call it Neon. Okay, now I'm going to turn this one off and just leave the 50 and the base. Edit, Define Brush Preset, and I'm going to call this Neon 50. Okay, I'm going to turn this one off and turn this one on, and I'm going to call this one Neon 25. So this number is just coming from how much I blurred out the tip, just so that you know what I was doing there. I'm going to turn these off, and I'm actually going to add two more layers. The first layer is just going to be a black layer. So this is, black is now my foreground color. I just clicked right here to reset it to default. So I'm going to press Option on my keyboard and Delete to fill that with black. Alt and Delete on a PC. And then I'm going to come to this. I'm just going to use this for drawing. So I'm going to come back in here to my brushes. You can see that I have these brushes that I just created. This one has all of them showing. So I'll come here to the brush settings so I can adjust that brush. If you don't see that there, you can come up here to Window and choose Brush Settings here. Now for this brush, I'm just going to take the spacing down to 5%. And I'm going to take this size down to 150 pixels. And I'm going to leave smoothing on, and I'll show you. This is optional. I'll show you what it does here in a minute. And I'm going to come here. Let me change the color here to like a blue. And this is our first brush. So I'm going to go ahead and save the changes to that. Okay, so I want to show you the difference between these three brushes just so that you kind of get the idea of the opacity. So on that first brush, we used three layers of opacity. So we had that 100%, 50%, and then 25% blurred. So this is going to be a much more opaque brush. So I'm just going to go ahead and draw a line using number one. Number two had a 50% and a 100%. So this one will be a little bit opaque as well, but you can see you're getting more of that fuzzy with this one than you are with this one. This is a little bit more opaque in that center section. This one's more fuzzy. It has less opacity to it. And then this one right here, we had 25% fuzzy on the inside and 100% on the outside. That means that this one right here is going to be much less opaque than the other two. So I'm going to draw that line. I just wanted to show you this so that you can understand the difference and why the opacity is so important for a brush like this, just in case you want to make other brushes based on something like this. So I left smoothing on, and that is so that I could have this available to me here. And this right here is just going to smooth out my strokes. So if you work in Procreate, you know that the streamline function smooths out your strokes. If you're doing that in Photoshop, this is where you go. I'm going to actually take that down to zero. And you can see my stroke there. So that's what that is. It's optional. You can either keep it on or turn it off. Now don't forget to go over to prettywebz.com to download these three brushes. There will be a link down in the description so that you can go directly to the page where these are, where this download is at. It's going to be inside of a yellow box. Always look for that yellow box for the download section. So if you have access to the lab, these three are going to be part of a bigger pack that I'm going to have available there. So you can go ahead and download those sometime this week. So if you want to get a copy of this extended pack and you do not have access to the lab, it's free. All you have to do is go to prettywebz.com and sign up at the footer of any page to get access to these brushes and many other resources. Until next time, thanks for watching.